Hello, hola, bonjour. Tune in every Tuesday to the Dear God Podcast.
¿Y qué pasó?
Nah, we talking like it's 1995. Let go of that Wi-Fi. Let's laugh and cry, but never say goodbye.
Hey, 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 you guys, and welcome to another episode of Dear God. Are we there yet? ¿Cómo está mi gente? Tenemos un primo, pero de lo máximo. We have an amazing guest on our show. And before I get into the show, I want to let everybody know that Dear God, are we there yet? Do not forget. It's just a metaphor. It's just something that was like we asked, Dear God, are we there yet? It doesn't mean anything behind it. You can be a believer of anything and everything. We talk about everything on this show under the sun because we're just talking like it's 1995. Pues sí, vamos a hablar hoy con Tom Garter. Garter? How do I say your name? Let me make sure I'm saying it right.
It's Scarta. So it's, if you look at the name, it's S and then the word card, C-A-R-D.
Ah.
Scarta.
Tom Scarta. How are you, Tom? And I want to thank you for being on my show today. I have so much to like talk about today in such a short time, but you are a number one bestseller for 3 books, and I know you're working on your 4th one, right?
I am trying hard, yes.
We're going to talk a little bit about that. So for you guys who do not know, Tom, tell everybody a little bit. I know who you are, but tell everyone from the show who you are, a little bit about you.
Absolutely, and thanks so much for having me on the show. I feel blessed and honored to be able to do
No problem.
So cool, and just loving your whole platform. This is such a great show that you have.
Thank you.
Very genius. So I'm a franchise guy. I'm a franchise expert, I guess. Primarily, I own a business that matches people with franchise opportunities based on skills and personality and goals, kind of like the eHarmony of business is what I like to call it. And I help people around the country figure out if franchising is for them, number one, and if it is, how to avoid pitfalls of choosing the wrong franchise, which a lot of people do. So my mission is to help people not do that. And the funny thing, Alicia, is I used to be a New York City subway conductor. So if you ever rode in the New York City subway, I am the guy, or I was the guy that opens and closes the doors and makes the announcements that are somewhat inaudible. And and it's interesting. One day, you know, an old timer there, I was young, I'm going back many years, but I'll never forget these kind of moments in your life. This guy said to me, "Hey kid, this is a great job because you'll always have a shirt on your back. It'll never be a silk shirt, but you'll have a shirt." And I thought, wow, bucket of cold water. That sounds like mediocrity to me. And I realized, oh my goodness, in that moment, I want to be a business owner because business owners were wearing those metaphorical silk shirts. My boss is who I love. You know, to this day, I was actually just at a retirement party last week for one of my old bosses. So still, you know, 20 years later, we still talk, but they were not living the lifestyle I wanted to live. And business owners, entrepreneurs, people that take risks, that's, I wanted to be in that world. And franchising was my foray into that.
Yeah, and I want to talk to you know, everyone on the show that franchise is something that a lot of people do not talk about, but it is a business and it is something, it can be very lucrative, like you said, if you find the hobby or the something that you love and you get the right knowledge. You know, I used to live in New York, and even growing up, my dad used to say, like, bueno, the whoever owns that subway, they're making a lot of money, you know, he would say that, or he'll be like, or Dunkin' Donuts. My dad, he's such a business. Oh my God. He always say that, like, Dunkin' Donuts. And I never understood what the whole platform of franchise is. And this is why, particularly, I mean, I saw your interview with Sarah, and then I was like, wow, we need to talk about this, because I know there's a lot of entrepreneurs that are listening, or they know somebody who wants to get into the business, but they don't really know, they're creative, you know, they have that creative mindset. And I saw that in your interview, you're just like, let go of perfection and let's just do it, you know, like just right or do, just do it. But what do you say to someone who's a creative and might be thinking about a franchise, and but the procrastination's like letting them stop them? Like, what do you say to them?
Well, it's, you know, any procrastination that happens is just your fear of the unknown, in my opinion. So sometimes it's crazy. There's a thing called fear of success. us, because deep down inside, mm-hmm. we know that, you know, we're children of God, and mm-hmm. we are powerful beyond we even know. And so people stop in their own tracks and they make their own obstacles. And, mm-hmm. you know, there's like this gray area. There's like, you know, work a job and pay your bills, or mm-hmm. take a risk and try to build something big. And, you know, no risk, no reward, as they say. But you really, you know, you'll never get past that fear. I have fear every mm-hmm. single day. It's just mm-hmm. the way.
And, yeah.
And I think I might have more fear than most people. And I think it's a lot has to do with the way you're brought up and, the you know, mm-hmm. what your parents, preachers, and teachers taught you. So for me, you know, I just tell people, listen, you got to get the knowledge. Knowledge will help you face fear. You'll never overcome fear.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, you have to overcome it, because you're never going to overcome it, like you said, because as you get in every part of your business, el negocio, just for everybody listening to my bilingual listeners, tú tienes una idea, and you're basically telling yourself, okay, I feel good right now. I'm in a high. Everything is going great. But then there's ups and downs. But with franchises, it's a little bit different, because a lot of stuff is done, already done, Tom, right? Like,
that's right.
People, their misconceptions. And I'm going to definitely tell everybody about the franchise coaching that Tom has on his website. Like, take advantage of that, because it's kind of like you said, it's a matchmaker. But the basics of this whole franchise thing is that everything's done kind of like a business in a box, right?
Yep. A business with training wheels. That's what I like to call it, Alicia.
Ah, okay. So it's a business with a training wheel. So is this something that, do you have to like heavily know about that industry, or is this something that you automatically get trained complete? Like, is it affordable? Do people can really, people obtain a franchise, or it's caro? Like, it's a lot of money.
So great, great question. So yeah.
And this keep it real.
Yeah. So here. Keeping it real. So here yeah. we go. I want to, so first of all, I want to say, you know, just thank you. And I know you have a great listenership, and just because people are fans of you, I want to make a special offer. If you don't mind, I just wanted to say,
of course,
if anybody wanted a free copy, absolutely free, no obligation copy of my number one bestseller, Franchise Savvy, just email me at tom@thefranchiseacademy.com. And I'll send you a real book in the mail. So, mm-hmm. again, it's tom@thefranchiseacademy.com, and you can get a free book. No obligations. You never have to talk to me. It's fine. But if you are thinking about franchising, you really need to know some of the pitfalls to not get caught up in.
Mm-hmm.
So to answer your questions, so a franchise, there's definitely an investment. I don't care what the business is. You need to have an investment mm-hmm. to get it off the ground. In a great franchise, you know, something that's going to actually make money, you need to be able to scrape together somehow, some way, around minimally $40,000 probably.
Mm-hmm.
And
that'll
get into a good business. I'm going to say, you know, if we're talking real, mm-hmm. you really, like, you know, with loans or, you know, however you get the money, really about $75,000 to really make it happen. So you could mm-hmm. make something that's going to replace your salary. And, mm-hmm. And that's important. So, what I always say to folks is, as you think about an investment like this, if you think about, you know, $50,000, just, you know, if you were blessed and you have $50,000, let's say in the stock market, and if the stock mm-hmm. market is doing well, you know, you're making like 7% on that money. But if you just round that up to 10%, because I'm not good at math, that's why I do.
It's okay.
but I'm being real. So just think about, if you took that 50,000, if you were killing it in the stock market, making 10%, that's $5,000 a year. If you took that 50,000, invested it in a business, can you make four times that amount of money? Because you need to count for the investment loss out of the stock market. So you got to make up 5,000, right? You got to make up for mm-hmm. your time. There's the opportunity cost. Can you make the profit? That's another, you know, 10%. So can you make, you know, $20,000 out of that investment? If you can, you know, you're essentially quadrupling your money by investing in the right
business. Of course. But so, Tom, you made a good point real quick. I don't mean to cut you off, but you made a good point. You said you have to do the math. At the end of the day, you have to do the math. Let me tell you something. If you, and I'm all about budgets. People can afford that, because a car right now, you can get a brand new car and people spend already $50,000 on a car sometimes. Or right. they can stop buying shoes and the Louis Vuittons and all that stuff, because it, again, it's a sacrifice. You know what I mean? Or they can even get, if they have great credit, because my father, we're Dominican. So my father used to say, in this country, if you have amazing credit, you're the richest person in the world, right?
That's true.
And because you can flip it, you can do all that stuff. So it's very possible. $75,000, if you think about it, you can't even buy a house for that. You can't even buy a piece of land for right. that in a good place. So to basically buy a business with training wheels and a box, I mean, of course, it's not always glamorous, everybody. There's going to be a lot of, you know, ups and downs, but at least the business comes with the basics of, yes, there is potential for success. And that's what you teach. That's what you coach mm-hmm. them, right?
Yeah, absolutely. So, Alicia, people don't realize it, but there's more than 4,000 franchises that span 90 different industries. It's not just fast food, which is always top of mind, and it was for me before I got into the business. So it's really mm-hmm. interesting. And also, I wanted to make a comment on another thing that you said in passing before, which is, you know, do you need to know that business or that industry? And the answer is absolutely not. They prefer if you don't. And so, as an example, this is kind of counterintuitive. If you mm-hmm. were a beautician, right, and you have your beautician license, chances mm-hmm. are very slim you're going to get awarded a Supercuts haircutting franchise.
Mm.
And the reason why is really twofold. One is they don't want you to come with bad habits, you know. They want to train you how to do it right because they are the professionals. That's why they've been doing it since, you know, in that company, 1986 is when they started, and they have, you know, 9,600 units around the world. They know how to do it. The other thing is like, if you're the beautician, right, and you have the barber license or whatever they call it these days, now, you know, Susie, your employee, calls in sick, and you're like, all right, so I'll cut some heads today. And then all of a sudden you realize, wait, maybe I don't need Susie. I'll just cut hair, and I'll save her
some.
And now what you did is you bought yourself a job, and that's not what you want to do.
No, you don't, because there's a difference. There's an absolute difference.
There's a major difference. So not to get too technical and in the weeds.
Of course, here, of course.
The way you got to look at this is that, you know, whether you, regardless of what you want with the money that you make, whether it's a job or a business, it's just a vehicle to get you that money. Is it whether to pay the bills or to buy a Maserati, whatever it is.
Mm-hmm.
It's
a vehicle,
right? So when you're looking at that vehicle, whether it's the job or the business, you got to know that you're going to love doing it every day. So it's not about what's the hottest franchise. That doesn't matter. You know, what's really funny, and you kind of touched on this a minute ago also, is that the businesses that you are going to look at most likely, if you want to look at very low investment, high margin businesses that people need and not want, they're very unsexy. They fly under the radar. They're things that people need. And it's not going to go away with the next recession or, you know, whatever is happening in the world. People need whatever it is. And that's, you know, if you want to build a legacy for your family, you know, if you want to build wealth, if you want to hand something down to your kids, I mean, that's the kind of stuff you need that has longevity, something that's not going to be replaced by Amazon.
Yeah. Well, and that's the thing where you're solving a problem. Like, I've been following business for a long time, and it's like, if you can solve a problem or it's something that is going to be a need ongoing, like an evergreen need, that's where the focus should be, right? That's where you know that someone's going to need those needles, or there's going to need this for whatever it is. You know what I mean? Like, the pharmaceutical industry has all these aspects of it. You know, because you're right. Just like, you know, people get, they get all the high off of these stocks sometimes, of these flyby companies that are just like, yeah, they're great today, and tomorrow they're like, ¿y dónde están? They're not even there anymore. But you mentioned something, and one of your books is called The Magic of Choosing Uncertainty. And a franchise, or just any business, anything in entrepreneurship, is, you know, that entire title of that book, The Magic of Choosing Uncertainty, in a nutshell, because I want people to go buy your book, but still, like, the uncertainty is real. It's like, oh my God, it's a big fear, because they have their bills, their everyday lives and stuff. But what do you mean by the magic of it? Is it just because it's kind of like the beautiful unknown of the gifts that come from it? Or like, in a nutshell, what do you mean by the magic?
Yeah. So the magic, when you choose uncertainty, right? Mm-hmm. So, and I always tell people, when you're looking for a franchise, you're working with me, I'm going to show you some great businesses. Your final mm-hmm. decision on what franchise to buy, you know, that's not what it comes down to. It's your choice is not the choice between franchise A or franchise B. Your choice is the choice between uncertainty or unhappiness.
Mm-hmm. Mm.
Most people choose unhappiness. And so what I mean by that is, you know, yeah, I got a job, you know, it's not making as much as I want to, but at least I'm paying my bills, you know.
Yeah.
And you're sludged to work and whatever. When you choose uncertainty, what you're choosing is faith in God. And mm-hmm. simply said, what's happening is you're saying, I trust in God enough that I'm able to walk off this ledge and I know that I'm going to grow wings because God got my back.
Yes, that's a right? faith. That's the magic of faith.
And that's magical. And it takes, yeah. it took me a lot of work to get there. Let me tell you, I didn't, you know, when the guy said, you're not going to have a silk shirt, I didn't quit that day. It took me about 12 years actually to make the move.
Wow.
I went to seminars, read books, you know, all that stuff, got educated, and all that education built up my faith. And, mm-hmm. and I prayed a lot and I did all of that. And I knew that it was a mission. And it's really interesting because my first business was a smoothie business, and mm-hmm. it was hugely successful. We did really well, and then somebody made me an offer. I was only in it for 5 years, and I sold it and semi-retired at 41 years old.
Wow.
And in itself, people say, how did you do that? And I was like, because I had faith in God. I knew that it wasn't going to fail, because God never puts anything in front of you that you can't handle. So mm-hmm. I knew that this came about for the right reason. So I jumped in and this guy paid me a bunch of money and I got out. Then we were going to buy a second franchise, my wife and I. She was retiring mm-hmm. actually from the NYPD. She was a New York City police officer. And she's like, hey, I want to buy this thing. She fell in love with this concept called Super Suppers, which real mm. quick, it's so great when you hear about it. It's a location where you come to our place. It's a studio kitchen. It looks like a Tuscan kitchen in Italy, and and it's beautiful. And you make dinners following our recipes using our ingredients. You make six at a time. You take them home, and you freeze.
Oh, nice!
Right on days that you're busy, you know, taking your daughter to dance rehearsal and soccer practice and everything else that's going on. Instead of ordering in pizza or Taco Bell, you can put one of these things in the oven and have a home-cooked meal in 20 or 30 minutes that you made with
somebody. Oh.
So brilliant, right? So my wife is on 11 different TV shows. I mean, CNN interviewed her. She was on literally the front cover of the Sunday New York Times in 2006.
Wow.
I could show you the article. And they said, we're changing the way America eats the way McDonald's and Swanson did
yeah.
50 years earlier. And I'll tell you, Alicia, in 19 months, we were out of business and lost almost our entire life savings.
Wow.
That's what made me
a flash.
That made me a franchise expert. That's when I really,
yeah.
you know, the winning thing, that was great, whatever. I didn't learn that much. But in the failure, yeah. I learned a lot. And so now, you know, that was now 11 years ago. And back then I was crying, literally. Now I look back on it as a blessing. I had to go through that so I could come out the other side and say to people, look them in the eye and say, listen, you don't want to buy that franchise because it doesn't have, you know, XYZ factors that you need in a business to be successful. I don't care that you love the way it tastes. That doesn't matter. You know?
Yeah. Yeah. The numbers, everything is in the numbers, you know, yeah. everything is, you have to, it's an emotional thing. I love that you said the lessons learned from failures is what makes you an expert. And a lot of people that know, I mean, I had a business, La Sewing Cafe, and it was very successful in Florida. It was a kids fashion design and sewing school, but I couldn't find reliable teachers. You know how they say, like, when your business grows a little too fast, it's not a good thing. You know what I mean? And that was one of my lessons that I've learned in life, where it's like, growing too fast is not a good thing, because now you have this business on top of you. And this is what makes you an expert, to know that what looks pretty might not always be the best. You know what I mean? But I love that you talk about those failures, because that is true. It's the magic is behind that, because it makes you see now a little bit differently. Tom, I want to thank you so much. I want to tell everybody again, you guys, if you're thinking about a franchise, and this is something that a lot of people do not talk about because they want to be an entrepreneur, they want to have their own business, but it is hard. It's hard to come up with a business plan and going to, you know, finding a location, all that stuff with it. When it comes to franchise, it's like a map for you. And he has franchise coaching, which is 100% free, right? That people come to you. And you guys can kind of break it down with the concepts and how to get involved and what will be the numbers and all that good stuff. You guys check him out. I'll have all of the information abajo de esto. I'll have it on the bottom. And all the podcasts, including my YouTube channel, I'll go ahead and have that information so you guys can reach out to Tom and ask him the questions, even if you're thinking about it or your wife or your husband thought about it or it came by like that laundromat or that this like my dad
right
I'm definitely going to personally tell my brother about this because I know we were raised with a father who was very business savvy and English is a second language and coming to this country and just building a business but he's always interested in coming up with a business. So I personally am going to tell my brother about this, but you guys, I have one more question for you, Tom, because I like to ask everybody a question. If you had a question for God or the universe, what would it be?
The question is, and I kind of know the answer, but my question is why? Oh. Why suffer? Why so much suffering? And so,
why suffering?
Right. Yeah. I'm trying to always kind of figure that. And I think that people create their own hell on earth, and that's all in their mind, and that's a whole another podcast we could do another day.
And you guys can also tune in, and he has the his own podcast. He's a podcast host as well. It's called the Franchise Academy Podcast. I will have that information below. Tom, I want to thank you. Muchísimas gracias por estar en el show mío and to be on the show for today. We're going to definitely leave the link, and he is giving away a book, a free book. What's the name of the book again?
It's called Franchise Savvy, 6 Strategies That Pros Use to Pick a Top Performing Franchise. So just email me at tom@thefranchiseacademy.com and give me your street address and I'll send you a real book, not a download. I'm giving you a real book.
A real book that you could touch and feel and smell.
That's right.
And get inspired. Bueno, thank you so much, Tom, for being on the show today. And you guys, remember, it doesn't sound easy. Some of these things, they just sound, like, wow, they're amazing, but they're possible. They are possible. And Tom he's living it today that everything is possible with just a little bit of, hard work and faith. At the end of the day, it's faith. So until next time, Tom, muchísimas gracias. You have a wonderful day and we'll see you again. Have a good one, everyone. Gracias, Tom.
God bless you.
Bye-bye. All right. Bye.